Hey everyone, welcome back. In this tutorial, we are going to simulate a tensile test using damage for ductile material. So we kick off with creating part. It should be 3D deformable solid extrusion and with the approximate size of 200. We are going to do the same modeling as the previous video, which was the ASTM E8 subsize. So this guy should be 10 and this two should be 30. Now we have to create two lines like this and a line like this. The distance between them should be 6 millimeter and each of them should be 2 millimeter away from the side. So yeah, that's cool. And we should create an arc like this and this, and also we are going to have them 12.5. Alright, cool. Now we have to create a construction line which we are going to do the symmetry on. So by left clicking on this one and holding, we can go for mirroring. We want to copy, we pick the mirror line and we choose all instances, and as you see here we have our model mirrored. This one should be 100, so yeah, that's okay. Now we want to use the depth, which is the thickness of the material. For this case is 2, and these lines should be extruded through the material, so we use the defined cutting plane, 3 points. This point, this point, and this point. We can create the partition. We're going to do the same thing for this part again. This one. I'm clicking the scroll button of the mouse. So, yeah. I'm doing it faster because we did all these things in the previous video. So we have our part created. Now we can go to the property. We are going to create the property for the material. We name it, steel. From general, we use the value of density. Here we have the value of the density, and the unit is ton over millimeter cubic. In the mechanical elasticity, elastic 210,000, and Poisson's ratio of 0.33. Now it's time to go for plastic. We have these values. Now here, let me talk about this part. So the first value of the yield stress is actually the yield strength, and the last one is the UTS, which is this part, sigma y0. And if we are going to use the simulation without the ductile damage, the curve would be goes like the dashed line, but we want to use a failure damage so that we can have a more realistic simulation. So we have to go in the mechanical damage for ductile material and ductile damage. Here we have a couple of fields that should be filled. So this one 0.35, 0.33, 0. And also we have to have the damage evolution, displacement, linear maximum, and 0.4. We click OK. Now we have to create a section. Homogeneous, and the material is steel. Now we want to assign the section. I would like to uncheck this one. Okay, now it turns green, and the material is assigned to the part. Now we're good to go for the assembly, create instance, and independent mesh. It's better to move the instance to this point, because we are going to create a reference point and it's easier to follow. So from tools, we go to the reference point and we use the value of 0, 100, and 10 and minus 0.4. Minus 0.4 is because we are going to opposite direction of the Z. So the reference point is created. Now we can create a set. The set manager, create, and let's say RP, and we select this RP reference point, and we have the set. Now let's go to the step. The step this time should be dynamic explicit. From the mass scaling, we use scaling definition below, create, and here we put the value of 1A-4, and we uncheck this scale by factor and okay. One important step is here to go to the field output, and from state we use the status, because we are going to simulate like the rupture here in the middle of this part. We want to see that, so we click on status in order to see that. And the next thing to do is to go to the history output. We double click on this one. We use set RP, evenly spaced time interval of intervals of 200. And we use U2 and RF2. We want to make sure that it's correct. Yeah, so this step is done. Now we have to go to the interaction and create a constraint of coupling, choosing the reference point, node region, clicking this part, and okay. Now this part is coupled to the reference point. Now it's time to go to the load. Okay, then we go to the boundary condition manager, create. First we use the symmetry and encast to encast the lower bottom part. Move to the left. Now create one from displacement type. We select the RP point. We select all of this and we click OK. Move to the left, but this one, keep in mind, we have to create an amplitude. So we say click and create an amplitude tabular, and I can use this one. I can copy here and Control C, Control V. From here we use the amplitude too I created. So dismiss. Now we can go to the mesh. Here from seed part I put this value on 1, mesh and we have the mesh. Also, we want to check the element types. So from here, it should be 3D stress, explicit. We uncheck this reduce integration, and I think it's okay. Now we're good to go to the job. Here, let's say tensile ductile damage. So we click OK, and from the job manager, I would submit it. Now the job is completed. We can go to the results. Okay, from the plot contour, we can contour the plot, see how damage happens. Here we can make it slower, or we can go manually like this, and we see here like the fracture happens. Let me switch to this part. Yeah, and the part is torn apart. And the thing about the status I told you about is to see this one. If you haven't checked the status in the field output variable, you are not able to see this one. Okay, so let's go to the ODB history output and choose these two and plot. We have the plot here. From the create XY data, let's go to the operate on XY data, and we can use combine here, U2, RF2, and plot the expression. So here we see that it start here linearly, and we had like the damage started from here, and it went to the 6 millimeter of displacement. What we can do right now is to go from here XY data plot and edit, and we select the first one, and by holding shift we can choose all of them and copy. Let's have them on Excel file. Here we can paste it. This one was this place meant, this one was the force. So to calculate the stresses and strain, first we're going to have strain here and stress for here. We have to divide the displacement by the gauge length, which is 25. Let me show you here. And this one, the gauge length is here 25. So we double click on this one. Now we calculated the strain. Now to calculate the stress, we have to divide the force by the area. So 6 millimeter times 2 millimeter, which is the width, the thickness, and we have the stress here. So as you see, this one, the width is 6 millimeter and the thickness was 2 millimeter. So here we have a stress and strain. We can calculate this, and there we go. All right, that's it. I hope you enjoyed the video, and if you did, please like this video and subscribe to the channel to see similar videos like this.